Agarose gel electrophoresis is a technique used to separate DNA fragments or other macromolecules, such as RNA and proteins, based on their size and charge. The first step for DNA fragment separation is the gel preparation or gel casting. An appropriate amount of agarose powder is weighed out. For standard agarose gel electrophoresis, larger molecules are resolved better using a low concentration gel, while smaller molecules separate better at high concentration gel. Once the agarose has been weighed, an appropriate buffer, such as TAE or TBE, is poured into the bottle. Agarose does not dissolve until it is heated. Therefore, the solution is heated for a few seconds in a microwave oven. Once the agarose is fully dissolved, the solution is cooled to about 55 degrees Celsius in a water bath. While the agarose solution is cooling, an electrophoresis tank, with a negative electrode and a positive electrode, is prepared for gel casting. A comb is placed in the tank to create wells for loading samples. Then casting dams are fixed in the tank so that the agarose solution does not flow out during setting. Once the agarose solution has cooled to about 55 degrees Celsius, and before pouring it into the electrophoresis tank, ethidium bromide is added. Ethidium bromide is highly toxic as a mutagen, so it must be carefully handled in a fume hood. Ethidium bromide is an intercalating agent, which intercalates between base pairs of the DNA molecule. When it is exposed to ultraviolet light, it will fluoresce, and DNA bands become visible. The more DNA present, the brighter the band. After addition of ethidium bromide, the agarose solution is poured into the electrophoresis tank. Then, the gel is allowed to solidify at room temperature. Once the gel has solidified, the comb is carefully removed, as well as the casting dams. Next, the gel is submerged in a TAE or TBE running buffer, which used to provide ions that carry a current and to maintain the pH at a relatively constant value. After the preparation of the agarose gel, the next step is the preparation of the DNA samples. A loading buffer is added to each sample. This buffer contains glycerol and certain dyes, such as bromophenol blue. And it is used to add density to the sample, allowing it to sink into the gel. To provide color and simplify the loading process, and to allow the user to monitor the progress of the separation. Before loading the samples into the wells, a molecular weight size marker, known as a DNA ladder, is commonly used as a standard reference that contains DNA fragments of known lengths. It is loaded into the first well of the agarose gel. Once the molecular weight size marker has been loaded, the DNA samples are loaded into the wells. After adding the samples into the wells, a lid is placed on the electrophoresis tank. Then, an electric current is applied to pull the samples through the gel. Based on their charge and size, the DNA molecules will travel through the gel at different speeds. The DNA molecules have a negative charge because of the phosphate groups in their sugar phosphate backbone. Therefore, when placed in an electric field, DNA fragments start moving through the matrix of the gel towards the positive pole. Because all DNA fragments have the same amount of charge per mass, small fragments move through the gel faster than large ones. Due to the relatively small molecule size of bromophenol blue, it migrates faster than DNA. And by optical control of the migrating colored band, the electrophoresis can be stopped before the dye, so before the samples have completely migrated through the gel and leave it. Once the DNA fragments have been separated, the gel is placed under UV light. Then, the DNA fragments can be seen as bands, Each band contains a large number of DNA fragments of the same size that have all traveled as a group to the same position. By comparing the DNA bands of the samples to the DNA ladder, we can determine their approximate sizes.